range, bro, I'm good with mine.
Hey, what's going on, Raider Nation? Welcome to another video for the Black and Silver Way. It's been a while since I made a video, so I'm going to go ahead and pretty much just catch you guys up on some latest Raider news. So this week's biggest setback, in my opinion, is going to be the injury of DJ Hayden. So far, it's been 3 weeks that DJ Hayden has been in a walking boot on a sprained ankle. Last season, he was hurt, and going into the season, he was already dealing with a life-threatening injury. So there's been nothing but injuries for our first rounder of last year, DJ Hayden. He's got to mentally stay into it, guys. He's had a lot of big-time breaks from football with all this injury, and he's come so far from the injury in college. He's been a year into the NFL. He played half of the season. He kind of got a taste of what it was like last year, but he needs to mentally stay in it because this game is definitely a lot of mental. You have to have a lot of confidence in this game, especially being a corner, knowing that you could shut the wide receiver down. So DJ Hayden's, injury again is a big setback. Dennis Allen does say that he will be ready for training camp in 5 weeks, but at the same time, they might take it easy on him. This has just been nothing but bad for DJ Hayden since he's been on our team. And I have all the best hope for DJ Hayden. I'm hoping that he could start. I'm hoping that he stays into the game mentally. But it's not looking good for DJ Hayden. Go ahead and comment below and let me know what you guys' thoughts are on DJ Hayden. Because honestly, this guy's missing a lot of football. Speaking of corners, actually cornerback Carlos Rogers, who we just picked up from free agency, has a minor calf injury, but it's nothing serious. Terrell Brown and Chimby Chekwa have been the starting cornerbacks this week in OTAs, and it's been looking good. Chimby Chekwa has been slowly making his way up our depth roster for the last 2 years, so I'm glad to see that Chimby Chekwa is still striving hard. And the one thing that is nice about Chimby Chekwa is he doesn't get injured. He fucking has not had an injury yet. So that's one good positive thing about Chimby Chekwa. I know he plays pretty good man-to-man. I know that he can work on the zone coverage, but we'll see how it works out with them. But I think Terrell Brown's definitely going to be our starting cornerback piece. He's still fairly young, and he's coming off of a really good defense with the 49ers. So I'm hoping that, he's going to be the top cornerback for us this year. And another thing is that Miles Burris, he had a great season in 2012, a great rookie season, and then in 2013 he got injured. So they brought in Kevin Burnett last year, and Kevin Burnett filled in and did a great job for Miles Burris. But we're going to have to start thinning out the numbers, guys, during this whole process of OTAs and training camp. And Miles Burris is full. He's not injured whatsoever. He's going good. And I know that Miles Burris is really, really shows a lot of potential that year. You could build around that guy. Same with C.O. Moore and Khalil Mack. They're all very young linebackers. Kevin Burnett is on the older side. And I think that, honestly, Miles Burris has already been seen. He's already in the first team reps already. And Kevin Burnett hasn't been. So I think that Miles Burris, if he's going to have no problem with injuries throughout this whole training camp, Kevin Burnett might not even make the team this year. I know he had a great season with us last year, but it's all about age, guys. And we still have Miles Burris in his rookie contract. It's going to save us money. And I want to see what he could be, because who knows? Maybe we have a star. So I'm thinking Miles Burris, C.O. Moore is going to be right beside him, and Khalil Mack. That right there is a great linebacker group, and I can't wait to see how it's going to pan out. And lastly, guys, the very important news, the something that the Raiders organization has needed for a shit load of time, is a quarterback, guys. Obviously, we brought in Matt Schaub, and Dennis Allen has been telling the media that that Matt Schaub has been looking great, and he's even exceeding than what he's expected from Matt Schaub. So that's good to see that Matt Schaub's looking good again, because he did have absolutely horrendous last season. But let's go ahead and forget about that. Maybe it's a Rich Gannon story. He's well aware of what happened with Rich Gannon. He revamped his career with the Oakland Raiders. He took us to that Super Bowl, and he didn't win. But that's a long story. I don't want to get into that. Anyways, guys, Rich Gannon was a great quarterback. And that's what the Raiders organization believed in Rich Gannon. Al Davis believed in him. And Rich Gannon's whole career got revamped. So Matt Schaub's very well aware of that. He's been trying to learn the the playbook as fast as he can. But the person that's breathing down his neck, which has put McGloin in the third spot already in camp, is Derek Carr. Derek Carr has been thrown into this playbook, guys, thrown into the NFL already, and he's been handling it very well. All the coaches, Greg Olsen, Dennis Allen, have said his willingness to work and his work ethic and his arm, everything is there, guys. I think this guy will be the future of the Oakland Raiders, but it will not be this year. It might not even be next year. Next year, he'll have a better shot at taking Matt Schaub's job, and I think that if Matt Schaub blows it during the middle of the season, of course, Derek Carr will start. But if Matt Schaub handles himself very well and handles himself off of the field, everything's okay, Matt Schaub is going to be our starter no matter what. But Derek Carr, this is the time to give him a playbook, and you learn it, and you learn it, and you learn it. Derek Carr is a smart kid. His brother's David Carr. He knows how to read off. He knows how to read defenses. So Matt Schaub right there to mold him as well. Derek Carr can definitely be the future of the Oakland Raiders. And I'm not saying that's a stretch, guys. That is not a stretch whatsoever. He's a smart kid. He loves the Raiders organization. He wants to stay right here in California. He's very comfortable already from what I've heard with the playbook and the passing. So I can't wait to see how training camp and preseason pans out so we can get him in the pads and we can see what he does on the field during preseason. And I want to see if Matt Schaub can handle himself, because I've seen Matt Schaub in interviews. I like the guy. He's a really nice guy. He seems like he really is all in for it this year, guys. He wants to try and win a Super Bowl for us, because honestly, Matt Schaub's never been there, and he is a quarterback that could take you to a championship. It's just the pieces need to get put together. I'm not saying we're going to win the Super Bowl, guys, but I'm just saying we have definitely a better chance at making the playoffs this year. And that's going to wrap up this video. There's not much news going on, but I know that Derek Carr, that's very exciting news for us, guys. He's showing really good work ethic, willingness to learn, and that's everything that you want in a franchise quarterback. So anyways, make sure to hit that like button, and I will see you guys in a week or so. Peace out, Raider Nation.